Be safe, please. Today we are going with a new topic, that is filariasis. Filariasis is also one of the arthropodal infection. Filariasis is caused by filarial worms. Filariasis is spread through the bite of infected mosquitoes. According to the periodicity and habitat, filariasis is divided into four: zoonotic filariasis, serious filariasis, subcutaneous filariasis, and lymphatic filariasis. Coming with the lymphatic filariasis, once again I will repeat the four filariasis according to the periodicity and habitat: lymphatic filariasis, zoonotic filariasis, serious filariasis, and subcutaneous filariasis. Coming with the lymphatic filariasis is a basic health problem in India. Which is a vector-borne disease or parasitic disease, which is caused by Wuchinaria bancrofti, Coming with the epidemiological triad, first one is Asian factor, the Brugia malai, Brugia tumori, and Wuchinaria bancrofti. Like that, 8 species are reason for the filariasis. Coming with the periodicity, the filariasis are, these worms have the nocturnal parasitic or nocturnal periodicity. We can see more in count at night time, but it will feed from bloodstream at daytime. Coming with the incubation period, 8 to 16 month is the incubation period for the Then coming to the reservoir, human and animals, but it is not a zoonotic disease, it is an arthropodal infection. Then coming with the vectors, Culex and Monsoonia. Culex is the responsible factor for Bancroftian filariasis. We can see more in count at polluted water. Monsoonia is the reason for the Brugian filariasis. We can see, or it is accompanied with aquatic plants. Then coming to the host, man is the main host for this, and mainly men is the main host for this, comparing with the females. Then age, all the age group may affected, but mainly 20 to 30 years of age. Then coming with the environmental factors, poor sanitation, climate, drainage, urbanization, migration of people. Are the environmental factors which is responsible for the filariasis. Then coming with the clinical manifestation, inflammation in lymph glands, filarial fever, lymphadenitis, lymphedema, lymphadenitis, lymphedema, filarial fever, inflammation in the lymph nodes. Then we can see asymptomatic microfilariemia. Then coming with the management, analgesics, oral antibiotics. If the wound is there, we can get antibiotic creams, then antiseptics. Once again, I will repeat: analgesics, antibiotics, antiseptic. If wound is there, we can use the antibiotics creams also. Then coming with the control, mosquito. Mainly we have to control the vectors like mosquitoes. Then filarial survey, entomological survey, mosquito control, sanitation and hygiene. Then coming with the preventive measures, avoid outbreaks We have to avoid the outbreaks, be aware of the ticks and arthropods, then be aware of the exposure, you have to wear the clothes which will cover all your body parts, then check for the ticks, then bed nets, you have to use bed nets and insecticides. Insecticides means which are the agent to kill the insects, which have the agent have the capacity to kill the insects. I hope you people understood. If you have any doubts, you can comment it. If you understood, please like my channel. Otherwise, you can comment it or dislike it. Please subscribe and please press bell icon also. Thank you. Thank you once again. Thank you. Be safe. Be safe, please.